Now is made possible by El Camino Hospital, Pandit Parashar, Building Kids, Ultimate Lounge, Yup TV, Intero, Calcos Financials. Hello viewers, welcome to Women Now. Thank you so much for being with us today. Women Now is the fastest growing South Asian TV talk show right here from the United States. Today we will start off the show talking to a poet who is also the spokesperson for Aam Aadmi Party in India, Kumar Vishwas. After the elections are over, we are talking still about politics. That's what party AAP has done for us. They have incited a feeling of politics in all of us, and they have created an uproar in India that is still worth talking about. And I'm so blessed today to be able to have a one-on-one conversation with none other than Dr. Kumar Vishwas.
Hello.
Who's been a poet, but today he's going to talk to us about his journey in poetry and politics. I mean, both starts with P. Strong words, both poetry and politics. Let's talk first a little bit about your poetic journey and what got you attracted to AAP.
Actually, these are the two different poles. It's 180 degree, because in poetry you have to come out with the reflections of your emotions very sharply and very wisely and very truth. And on the other hand, politics that is believed in, you have to hide your reflections, whatsoever you are thinking, whatsoever you are coming out with. But I still believe that we, either me, Arvind, or so many new crusaders of politics, they are coming on in Indian political platform. They are not here to do politics. They are here only to change the politics, the way of thinking.
Right.
And we are far ahead. If we think about 4 years back when India was an Indian youth on Facebook, on Twitter, on any social networking platform, either at the time Orkut was very popular, and they were talking about all about IPL, about new films upcoming, about how Saif Ali Khan has created a tattoo on name of Karishma or Kareena Kapoor, I don't know even his her name,
yeah.
Sorry for that. I'm a bad man in the films.
Mm-hmm.
So now everyone is talking about governance, about politics, either or against mm-hmm. of anyone.
Right,
they have
right.
high hopes Mr. Modi government.
It's become a part of everyone's life. It's because they've seen the change and the ability to have a voice. I think what you have done as a party, what you've accomplished is giving everybody a voice. Now everyone can stand up and say something. And we from here, this far from India, have learned so much about politics that I've not learned in many years.
I came to interact with several young people around the globe in US or in Japan or wherever I visited, and they told me that before you guys, you were not thinking about politics. You were
right.
not even concerned about who is ruling
right.
and what type of governance is going on.
Right.
We were full of criticism ki is desh mein kuch nahi ho sakta, yaar
exactly.
India mein kya hoga,
yeah.
yaar chodo. Now there is a hope.
Correct.
If people are voting for Mr. Modi,
mm-hmm.
It's a matter of hope.
Right, right.
It's a matter of marketing also.
Right.
They have done a wonderful marketing.
I think what you meant to say is that you're not against a party or you're not against a person. What you're against is corruption. So that was the core essence of what you were
Definitely.
Doing.
I'm very happy with this new election. Though I met with the defeat in Amethi, I mm-hmm. toiled a lot and I sweated a lot in Amethi constituency for more than 3 months.
Mm-hmm.
But the new elected government is a common voice of this country.
Correct.
And if they are able to come out with strong rules like Lokpal, if they are able to throw Mr. Nihal Chand, who is a rape accused and a cabinet minister of Mr. Modi, that's a mm-hmm. good thing for me.
Right.
And if
that's what you wanted.
That's what I want and why mm-hmm. every Indian wants. But if Nihal Chand is still having a position in that government,
mm-hmm.
Then the crusade is still on.
Correct.
I am still on the roads and I am still raising the voice as I was raising in the Damini time.
I am very curious. You know, we all fight different battles in our life and we have ups, we have downs and all of that. But fighting a battle like you did and then not being able to get what you exactly wanted. What was the moment like for you, and how did you control yourself, and how did you keep moving on, and how do you look so relaxed and happy today?
Actually, what's the motive of your battle? That is very important. So when I landed in the podium of Amethi and in this Western of Gandhi's, that was my statement, my party's statement, that the dynasty rule is the worst thing in a democracy.
Right.
So no one was interested to get a head on with that Gandhi clan.
Mm-hmm.
And they have a very comfortable tie up with each other, say aap hamare yahan mat ladna, hum aap kya nahi ladenge. As Mr. Mulayam Singh was not facing any Congress candidate, and Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi was not facing any Samajwadi candidate.
Mm-hmm.
They were against in parliament with each other's party, but they're mm-hmm. saving their daughter-in-law, their mother-in-law, their
right.
father-in-law, their son and the sisters.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going on more than a family club. So Priya
right.
Sule is there and Sharad Pawar is there.
Mm-hmm.
Madhurav Sindhya was there, Jyotiraditya Sindhya is there. Mr.
Mm-hmm.
Pilot was there, the next pilot was there.
Mm-hmm.
Sonia Gandhi is there, usse pehle Rajiv Gandhi was there. Well, what it is going
it
on?
It wasn't defining democracy
so when,
and the voice of the people.
Definitely. When Prime Minister Mr. Manmohan Singh, ex-Prime Minister, whenever he said that I am ready to give up my prime ministerial post for Rahul Gandhi.
Mm-hmm.
More than 3-4 times he came out with this statement.
Yeah.
Actually, he was abusing the whole young Indian talent.
Correct.
Who was rising around the globe mm-hmm. without the identity of their parental hoods.
Right.
If you are taking my interview, I do not know your father and mother's name.
Right.
And I am interviewed here on this such a wonderful show.
Mm-hmm.
You hardly knows my father's name.
Correct.
I am here because of my work, whatever I did.
Right.
It was good, it may be bad.
Right.
It
right.
may be good, but whatsoever
right.
you may be a good host or a bad
right.
host.
Right.
But whatsoever you are doing, it's due to your own talent.
Yeah, and you have to give chance to the larger
so
muscle.
So what like Rahul Gandhi did
say, yeah,
to the country.
Yeah.
He was a national burden and he's a national burden. And
right.
no one was having that guts to come out and said that gentleman has ruined all the 10 years in the parliament.
Mm-hmm.
And that gentleman has ruined Amethi constituency also.
Right.
So I was the first man. So I lost the election. But I hope the question what I raised that was very, very valid, and across the globe and every media corner and every street it was picked up like anything and people were talking about it, and I'm happy with that.
Now Kumarji, what got you attracted to AAP? I mean, Aam Aadmi Party came to you or you went to them, what was that moment like?
No, actually it starts in 2010-11 when Anna Andolan was on papers.
Okay.
And it was taking a shape in drafts, and Arvind and Manish and all those good friends were working on it. And Manish is a childhood friend, Arvind is an old friend, and they approached me because I was at the time even I was popular in young generation in engineering colleges. My poems were very popular, Koi Diwana Kehta Hai, Pagli Ladki and all those, and Tiranga.
So you were a people's person.
Yeah.
I mean, people's person always helps to be in
so
politics.
So they asked me to give 1 week only.
Mm-hmm.
And they said ki agar aap ek hafta de do yaar to youth aa jayega. और यूथ अगर जुड़ गया तो बहुत अच्छा हो जाएगा. सो आई रेडिली एग्री कि इट्स ओके, एक हफ्ते की तो बात है, लेट मी कम आउट. एंड आई जॉइन दैट मूवमेंट, एंड सडनली वाइल मास्टरिंग ऑल दैट सेरेमनी एंड यू नो डूइंग ऑल द थिंग्स ऑन स्टेज एंड टेकिंग केयर ऑफ ऑल ऑफ द प्रोसीडिंग्स ऑफ अन्ना आंदोलन एंड अन्नाज अनशन एंड अरविंद अनशन, आई बिकेम द माउथ पीस ऑफ दैट मूवमेंट in press, in general, because mujhe
it was an induction.
Right?
Yeah.
And government start victimizing me.
Mm-hmm.
I was doing a university job.
Mm-hmm.
It was excellent job. For last 17 years I was serving the university and everyone was happy. My department,
mm-hmm.
my principal, each and everyone was very happy. My students. And suddenly my university and my college came to know that I am good for nothing. They issued so many of show cause notices. They unhone meri salary band kar di and all that because mere pa income tax ka chhapa pada. Because they were in that mood ki kisi tarike se isko yahan se hata le.
Mm-hmm.
It should not come out so loud against
mm-hmm.
corruption.
But there was a very short period in time wherein you were very popular, right? Everyone was talking about you and Arvindji and all. What was the change in your mindset to handle that popularity? Because, okay, you're known in college, you're known, you're a popular person, but all of a sudden then you're a celebrity, right? How did you handle that? I mean, I used to wonder that how is Arvindji handling and you are handling that much of people rushing behind you and that much of attention and that much of public, you know, scrutiny?
The last thing is much more important, the public scrutiny, because now we are very socially responsible person. We should, because before that, as a performer, as an artist, I used to say a lot of things. I used to do a lot of things. Jo bhi generally ek kalakar karta hai, bolna. But while I was in election campaign and I was raising voice against corruption, against that time government, Manmohan Singh government, and I was coming out of the street with young girls and boys at Damini time, mm-hmm. and Gudiya rape time, and police beat us so badly, blue and black. So from that time, now they dig out my old videos and post it on social networking site. As I cracked joke on Santa Banta or anything else, so they cut it and posted it, Kumar Vishwas insulting Sikhs.
Right.
I cracked a joke on someone else and they mastered it and said Kumar Vishwas insulting Islam.
Right.
So they do want to pour hatred in the common people who were the listeners of mine, who were the admirers of mine, against me. But I interacted people more and more. I wasted my time, invested my time on social networking site and come out with my logic and my things. And soon लोगों को पता चला कि ऐसा नहीं है, they are the good person और वो लोग कुछ करना चाहते हैं, कुछ बदलना चाहते हैं, and we are successful enough that we have changed it.
Right. And tell me a little bit more about the future. What is it looking like for you the next 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, 5 years? Where am I going to see you?
Actually, what we did 3 years back, we start raising questions. Whatsoever is going on bad in the country, either it was Commonwealth scams, coal scams or 2G scams. Prashant Bhushan started it in courts. Anna Hazare started it in Ramlila Maidan. We started it in news channel. Arvind started in other things in public meetings and rally. Several people started it. And now the raising question is a common habit in Indian democracy. And that is a beautiful thing. If every citizen has its question, government has to take care of all questions and has to address them. So you can't hide your face against this
and
logic that you're
now... media is very much behind you because media is exposing every corrupt politician.
I think. I'm not agree with that. Media is exposing every... They have their own agenda also, and now corporate houses has taken media.
Right.
They have taken a big share.
But still, I see a lot of media having stipulated hour wherein they have to have the janta ask questions and the politicians answer. I mean,
in India, media is not as much mature as it should be because... the investment of corporate houses who are sucking the blood of motherland. Money talks definitely.
Yeah.
So how they dare to come out with real truth.
Correct.
So they are imposing their agenda, they are imposing their instructions which they get them from their godfathers, political godfathers or corporate godfathers.
Right.
So social networking media is much more trustworthy and we are doing more work on that. Because if I do something, I was awarded by California State Assembly, but it was not taken in that manner in Indian media. Otherwise, if I have committed sin here, they might have put it in such a big way, Kumar Vishwas ke saath ye hua, fala hua, and they might do each and everything. So we are not very much focused on the mainstream media that's called television. We are focused on social networking media where we can argue, we have a two-way business.
Correct,
if I post something, people come out with their comments and I go through all that comment and I have, try to address all these questions which are raised on that platform.
Right. Now, I want to personally congratulate you on your strength and your accomplishment and your achievement and your purpose, your vision, your mission.
Thank
I think I have been inspired that someone could really do what all of you achieved with a team. And I'm sure the teamwork has been phenomenal with a great leader, and I wish you a lot of success in the coming years. But we can't let you go before you say a nice poetry that comes to your mind right now particular situation sitting here.
And I do want to urge your listeners that why they are happy with the politicians like Lalu Yadav, Mulayam Singh, Phulan Devi, Pappu Yadav, they are comfortable with them. But when someone like Arvind Kejriwal, who is in IIT and who is IRS, someone like Manish Sisodia, who is a television presenter and a producer, someone like Yogendra Yadav, who is a professor, someone like Ashutosh, who is CEO of a channel, if someone like Kumar,
you, who is a poet.
Who is a poet and a professor. I served university for 17 years.
Right.
If he is trying to come out with his political aspirations or political thought process, they are full of abuses. Few of them are full of abuses. What the hell you are doing? Why you are going political?
Every change will have a pushback.
I'm
happy that you are still strong enough to fight the battle. Every change takes
time. What we did is ki kuch deshbhakti ke mantra yahan humne aakar baache to hain. Hum deshdroh ke vishdhar ke phan par chadkar naache to hain.
Right.
Bhrashtachar ke andhad ko aage bada lalkara to hai. धीमा ही सही तमाचा पर उसके मुंह पर मारा तो है. तो वी हैव इनिशिएटेड इट, वी हैव स्टार्टेड इट.
राइट,
लेट दिस जर्नी गो ऑन.
एंड आवर शो इज वुमेन नाउ. आपका फेवरेट वुमेन पोएम?
आई हैव कंपोज्ड ए पोएम ऑन दामिनी आल्सो, बट इट्स अ लॉन्ग पोएम. आई कैन कंक्लूड इन फ्यू लाइंस कि तुम्हें देखा तो नहीं कभी अपनी जीवन की भागदौड़ और तुम्हारी बेचैनियों में, लेकिन अगर हो सके तो अगले जन्म में मेरी बिटिया बनकर पैदा होना, ताकि मैं तुम्हें बता सकूं कि पुरुष होने से पहले मनुष्य होता है हर मर्द.
थैंक यू सो मच.